I drove all the way down from 395, driving by towns like Uncasville, Ballouville, Moosup. It's the freaking Dr. Seuss corridor of Connecticut. Seriously, I pulled over and got a 6-piece McNuggets and some green eggs and ham. Because I would eat them in a car. Seriously, God. Charlton Heston passed away, how about that? That's a shame. You think he's regretting that whole cold dead hands comment? You think he remembers? Sorry, that's cruel. I heard at his funeral they did a 21-gun salute with AK-47s. That was the quickest one ever. Tell you a little bit about myself. I'm an identical twin. Do we have any twins in the audience? Anyone? Yeah? Any sisters? I'm a mirror twin. Are you fraternal or identical? All right. I'm a mirror twin. I'm left-handed. My brother's right-handed. You know about that? I got a birthmark on my left knee. He's got a birthmark on his right knee. I'm straight and he's gay. I wish that were a joke. That's right. There's somebody out there that looks exactly like me that likes to take it up the ass. But the surprising thing is, I don't mind being confused for him. People go to me like, "Are you Brian?" I'm like, "Do you want me?" How you doing? Hey, how you doing? All right. Yeah, call me. The signs were always there. I should have known he was gay. In elementary school, I got in trouble for teasing the girls. He got in trouble for teasing their hair. Even earlier, I should have known he was gay. By the way, he wanted to decorate the womb. You should see what we can do with this placenta. Growing up. The problem is, he's gay, so he's in great shape, and I'm not, so we're more like Funhouse Mirror Twins. I do have to lose weight. I just went to the bathroom. Guys, back me up. I love this place. It's a classy place, but Marissa's needs to widen the dividers in the urinals. And then I had to walk in with some butter for my elbows. I do. Here's how you know it's time for you to lose weight. When you get on an elevator and it becomes easy for you to divide your weight into the capacity, then it's time. Like, holy shit, only two of me can ride this. Wait a second, that's my weight. And then when you're walking down the street and you activate a stoplight, then it's time for you to lose weight. I caused 3-4 car accidents. I don't know what happened. A light turned red. Oh, there's Andy. And my wife's pregnant. And when I do the laundry, and I actually have to think twice about whose clothes it is, it's time for you to lose weight. I'm like, oh, wait, this is mine. No, it's not. That's tough. I've tried everything. I've tried deal a meal, sweat to the oldies. I'm so lazy, I can't even sweat to Yanni. Tell us all about myself. My last name's Paquette. I'm French and Irish. Do we have any of that combination in here? Half French, half Irish, half? All right, you know what that means? I'm a great lover, but usually too drunk to get it up. And halfway in the middle of sex, I surrender. But then I blow up her car when she leaves. So, I have a very rare disease, too. I have a very rare disease called OCED-ADD. Obsessive compulsive erectile dysfunction attention deficit disorder. And what that means is I'm overly concerned about my inadequate junk, but 10 minutes later I forget why. I kid you not, there's a magazine, an ADD magazine. I was reading the first article, and at the bottom of the article it said continued on page 20. How cruel is this? It's so wrong. I always like to wrap up with a little story I tell because I kid around about drinking and moderation stuff and everything. I did a show and I get off stage and I'm sitting at the bar. This lady comes up and she looks at me. She's like, "You know what? You look like Kevin Bacon." You know what I mean? Like, I look like Kevin Bacon if all he ate was bacon. It gets better. I told that story to Rocky's Applause at a place in New London, Connecticut. Clearly, I have no agent. And I get off stage, and this guy comes up, he's got tight jeans, tight black shirt, short cropped hair, jewelry, clearly gay, not as gay as you, but close. So, he says to me, he says, "You know what, you do look like Kevin Bacon." and I like bacon. I'm getting hit on by a gay guy. So then I tell those two stories, and a lady comes up to me afterwards, and she's like, you know what, you don't look like Kevin Bacon. She's talking to me, she's like, you look like meatloaf. Like, you know what, I look like meatloaf if all he ate was Kevin Bacon. I mean, if I kept